hate them. Always have, always will. My friends will think they're cute, but they're really not. They're horrible.
We're getting calls in where people have had their cats killed. Several times last year, children have been bitten by foxes whilst they were asleep in their own beds. A friend of mine had her tortoise, who was 70 years old, and bit its front leg off, you know, which was a real shame, you know. We've been doing this in London now for 30 years. I mean, there is more foxes now in London than I've ever known before. Oh,
hi,
hello
Mr.
there.
Bruce.
Yeah, I'm Bruce Howard. Howard.
Yeah,
hi, pleased to meet you. Pleased to meet you.
Come very recommend, highly recommended by friends.
Oh, good.
So let's go through and see what the problem is.
Yes. Yes, certainly.
What's the best thing to do with them?
Well, we can either trap them or shoot them.
So if you trap them, what do you do with them afterwards?
Well, that really is entirely up to the client. I mean, personally, you know, we've got to go and do exactly what the client wants. I mean, some people insist they want them released unharmed.
Right.
But a lot of people feel that that's like dumping your rubbish onto their someone else's doorsteps. So most people, and for the fox's benefit, it's probably kinder to be humanely dispatched.
Yeah.
That's my certificate, the license to...
And a pistol.
Yeah, we often use pistol for humane dispatch of trapped animals or foxes underneath people's sheds, you know, when you've got a litter of cubs. Yeah.
Foxes aren't protected. They're classed as pests. Bruce has a license to kill.
Right, I would say that that window in the rear addition there would be a good place to shoot them from.
Right.
You've got a nice downwards trajectory there.
Yeah. What do you use?
We use a 2-2 rim fire.
Right.
With a sound moderator and night vision scope on it.
So it's a 2-2 slug?
Yeah, yes. Well,
but not too high velocity?
Not high velocity, no, it's subsonic.
Right, right. Are they soft-nosed then? They break up on
impact?
Yeah.
Mm. Yeah, they don't break up on impact, they just fold up, you know.
Right.
So they double in size, basically.
Yeah, oof, nasty.
Yeah.
But effective.
Yeah. Oh, very effective, yeah.
What then am I going to need to do to prepare things for you then?
Well, what I'll do is give you some tins of food.
Okay.
And I want you to put them out each evening.
You want them in the middle here, clear of the sides.
Yeah, around here would be perfect.
Great. Sounds good.
Great.
Let's go.
For a week, Howard sets his trap. Now, pregnant, timid vixen needs more to sustain her, and she joins her partner in the search for food. And Howard's garden has become so inviting. The chicken may be off, but the special is to die for. Thanks to Reg's efforts, our mother, Miss Fox, is well again.
When you see them in a sorry state and you can't get them better, that's when it hurts. But the most joyful part about it is you rescue them, they go away for convalescence and get better. And it will be taken back to the spot where we got it from in the garden. It's not supposed to take them away. It does carry a sentence, like a crime, wildlife crime, if you do that. And that's the most rewarding part of it, I tell you, it's brilliant.
The family who discovered her under their decking don't want her back, so good practice requires she's released as near as possible.
Someone's coming. Who is it?
Can't quite recognize it at the moment.
Is it Is it our little Miss Fox?
Good God, it could be.
I can't see her tail properly.
Very calm.
Is it, Helen? Is it?
Well, come on, little Miss Foxy, move
around
a bit.
Show us your tail, then we'll know.
Just a minute. That's definitely her. Look at her tail. Yes, that's definitely her.
Oh, we've got little Miss Fox back again.
And in pretty good shape.
Yeah. She's in really good shape. What's she been up to these last 3 weeks?
God knows.
Oh, isn't that great to have her back?
We thought that we'd seen the last of her.
Yeah, we did. So it's so good to see her back again.
Yeah.
Just streets away, our young couple are thriving. Weeks away from giving birth, timid Vixen can expect around 4 to 5 cubs. And the couple are still enjoying their nightly picnics in Howard's garden.
In the rainforest shooting with a 22 long rifle.
Did you eat what you shot at?
Everything.
Really?
Never shot anything you didn't eat.
No. What about snakes?
Yeah, they ate snakes sometimes.
Did they?
Yeah. And a lot of caterpillars and ants and all that sort of stuff, you know. Tasted great.
We didn't shoot them though.
I once shot a fish.
Did you?
I did. So this is the anchovies then?
Yeah, this is the anchovies.
Right.
And it's bolt action.
Yeah.
With a 5-shot magazine, right. And this is night vision scope.
Fantastic.
This is military spec.
Yeah. And you're left-hander?
And I'm left-handed.
It's got shells in it, hasn't it?
No, it hasn't. So you've taken completely them out, empty, yeah.
Because for me, this is all last about
all the wrong way around, yes.
Yeah. Very, it's nicely balanced there. Bit of nose weight because of the silence.
Oh, yes, yeah.
That's good.
Excellent. Yeah, they're nice, nicely made little rifle.
Yeah.
Timid Vixen's hungry again. She heads straight for Howard's.